story of Fishbone is making its way across our nation. The director is right here. His name's Chris Metzler. He's a local guy to tell us about. You went to Fort Osage?
Yeah, graduated in 92 and then went out to Los Angeles to go to film school at USC.
Oh, man, I've been there. That is a cool school. A lot of people want to go into filmmaking. Mm-hmm. You have done it. Not everyone gets to achieve their dream. How come you're successful?
I guess I just pursue it with passion and verve. I mean, I couldn't imagine doing anything else. So I think that's the thing that kind of keeps you kind of working 24/7, just trying to put together projects. And, you know, I have fun with it. So
how'd you come up with this idea?
A friend of mine had told me about the band Fishbone. I never was a fan of their music or even familiar with them. But once he told me the story about these six black kids from South Central LA that got bussed out to the suburbs and fell in love with punk rock and then really just kind of changed the music scene, I was like, that sounds interesting to me.
It is interesting. Did you get to know these guys?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, we spent 3.5 years making the film. We would spend a week each month filming with them, and we also went on tour with them in Europe several times and also in the U.S. So, you know, when you're living with them 24/7, you know, for, you know, months at a time, obviously kind of friendships get created from that.
What was their fascination and is their fascination with punk rock?
You know, I think the thing about it is that there are two things about punk rock. Is one is that they're stage diving and mosh pits, and so, you know, the concert's just this really cool live experience. But then also, you know, whoever's on stage, they're not better than what's in the crowd. And so I think they like the idea of creating this sense of community at a concert, in the sense that the crowd and the band is all one and like part of this large performance.
It's kind of odd, though, because you don't see a lot of white rappers. There's a few. And in turn, you don't see a lot of black punk rockers.
Absolutely. It's a very segregated music scene, which is kind of unfortunate. But obviously, that's one of the things that, you know, made Fishbone difficult to kind of market, in the sense that they're like, well, who wants to go see these, you know, six black guys playing punk rock? But in the end, you know, they're a band that was so hugely talented that they've influenced folks like the Red Hot Chili Peppers, No Doubt, Outkast, Black Eyed Peas. I mean, huge multi-platinum,
Peas, yeah.
You know, selling, you know, bands.
If you want someone to go see this and take one thing away from your film, what would that be?
I think the thing about it is, like, whether you like the guy's music or not, they've lived really interesting lives and are just kind of quirky, interesting people. And so I think there's something about their passion and, you know, their kind of determination and kind of carving their own path that basically you can do and achieve what you want. And there's these different risks and rewards. But if you're having fun with it, you might as well keep on doing it.
Seems like you've done that yourself. Thank you, Chris, for being with us today.
Thanks for having me.
All right. Well, Everyday Sunshine, the story of Fishbone, is playing at the Screenland Crossroads tonight through Sunday. Showtimes are on.